So what's hip? What is a hip? If you live in San Francisco, some people would claim that these guys, these hipsters, are what's hip. I'd say it probably depends a little bit. But the hip, when people say their hip hurts and they come into my clinic, doesn't really tell me much because a lot of people think of the hip as a much different, it could be anywhere. Some people think of low back. Some people think lower down on the buttock area. Some people kind of grab the side of their pelvis up high, say that's their hip. Other people, it's more the kind of a little farther down. This is what classically an orthopedic surgeon would call the hip. But you know, the hip could be a variety of different locations to different people. But when an orthopedic surgeon is talking about a hip, we're talking about this top portion of the femur. So I think you guys can see my arrow, but the top portion of the femur, kind of involving the femoral neck, this area called the inner trochanteric region, and then this upper part of the femur. That is technically what the hip is. And then the hip joint is the ball and socket joint. So the ball here and the socket acetabulum. That's what a hip is to an orthopedic surgeon. The anatomy of the bones of the hip. You can think of, we talked a little bit about the femur already. That's the thigh bone, the top of the femur being the hip. We can break it down as the ball or the femoral head. There's also a portion called the femoral neck right below it that attaches it to what we call the inner trochanteric region. And that inner trochanteric region is called that because it's between two trochanters. Trochanters are these bony prominences. This one on the top of the femur is called the greater trochanter because it's bigger. And the second one is called the lesser trochanter. Those are two really big and important attachments of two muscles that we'll talk about in a minute, but kind of two important landmarks on the hip bone. Now, the other side of the hip joint, the ball and the socket side is called the acetabulum. That's a bony socket lined with cartilage. It's a part of your pelvis. Now, your pelvis is considered this whole section, two bones, two inanimate bones, and then the sacrum. Each side of the pelvis can also be broken down into an ilium or the iliac wing. That's kind of that higher bony part that you can feel pretty easily. And then the ischium and the pubis are the two other parts of that inanimate bone. And then the sacrum behind it being the bottom of your spine. So those are kind of bony landmarks there.